Hello and welcome to the crossing of trains in Train Fever. Yeah, that's where we are, and we are just watching as these two lovely trains cross each other. A beautiful sight it is, and it's all happening on our network that is becoming more and more mature with each video that we play Train Fever. Now, this, you know, this town Rayleigh is the last town we hooked up. And I think that all we need to do right now is just give it some proper time to develop itself and grow and generate more money for us. I mean, look, we even built this road so that houses can be built alongside it, and yeah, this, it just needs time, that's all, basically. And we'll give it some time, because there's plenty of other things that we need to be looking into. Well, you know, for one, I don't really know if this train line that we got going over here for the wood is actually big enough. I mean, how much is waiting over here? Wow, 30 wood. And how much capacity did our train have again? 16, huh? That's with 4 trains. Or 4 wagons. So, what we need is another, I don't know, 4 wagons? Yeah, I think another 4 is actually what we're gonna need. Because there's 30 waiting there already. Once the train has arrived over here, they will only be waiting even more. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna send this train to the depot once it's over here, and then we're gonna add as many wagons as we need to have this be pretty much fully loaded. So yeah, let's get that done first. Right, and it's going to the depot right very now. So once it's inside, I'll pause the game so that we can see how much is mounting has mounted up there. But I'm pretty sure that it's more than 32 already. So let's see, 36, huh? That means that we would need 10 freaking wagons on this train. Fine, if that's what it takes, then we'll build 10 freaking wagons on this train. Right, okay. I didn't expect to be needing that much. But, yeah, well, okay, good then. 10 wagons it is, so that means, you know what, let's quickly check out how we have set up that line, though. I do believe that, yeah, it's Rayleigh Wood, which is set to full load. Alright, so we definitely do need them 10 wagons. So, goods wagons it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh man. Craziness, I tell you. Right, well, let's unpause it, because right now we got a serious train over here. Yeah, that's accelerating a lot slower right now. A lot slower, I'm telling you. But this is now a serious freaking train. And, well, you know, I mean, we've taken care of this business. I do hope that, yep, no, all the wood's still going there. Nothing has, like, taken a sneaky route like this to our fire or our sawmill. So, yeah, we're not missing out on anything, but wow, look at this train, man. Serious business, I'm telling you. Now, the other thing that I would want to take a look at is this station over here. See, right now there's 11 folks waiting, and the train has just left. It has just passed the bridge, and over here, look, there's 46 people waiting, but when we go and take a look at the capacity of this train, there can only be 42 passengers on board. And that's a problem. And I'll tell you why that is a problem. Because, That means that we won't be able to take everybody from this station. And look, there's 48 and it's just mounting up. So by the time the train will get here, there's probably like 10 or more passengers that we cannot even take. However, well, there's two things we can do. Or we add more wagons, or we add another train to this line. Now, actually, I do believe that we have better wagons for this passenger line. But the thing is, once we do that, you know, add in more wagons, that means that we have to take the train from the line. And only then will it be able to get more wagons. And that means that we won't be able to get any passengers onto these stations. Now, that usually, I mean, we've had to do that once already. And as you can see, passengers are clearly coming, but I don't know. I think what we should do also, you know, with the eye on the future and the future growth and expansion of our towns, I think what we should do is add another train to this passenger line. Yes, I think that that would be the smartest way to go, but look at that, 53. But if we are going to add another train to this line, that would mean that we have, on this particular stretch over here, we would have, well, if I'm not mistaken, 3 trains. And 3 trains with just these bypass thingies in there is not going to work. So if we're gonna get a third train, what we would need to do is make it proper 2-lane. And not with just these bypass areas. So, you know what? That's exactly what we're gonna do. Now, I've just paused it so I can see that this train's over here. Now at this crossing, you know, the thing is, here on this stretch, from the bridge till this junction, we have 3 trains. And that's where we're gonna need proper 2-lane tracks, you know? For this stretch though, when it's only 2 trains, I think we can get away with the bypass section, so we don't need that. But yeah, it is pretty much most definitely needed. So, we're gonna get ourselves another train on this one, and we do need the tracks to set that up. Another thing that I'm just now seeing is that if we zoom out over here, I mean, this is the station, huh? So we follow the tracks and there's no freaking depot. There just isn't any. I mean, we've got one over here. I guess that could do service, really. See, the thing is, once these trains, once we got 2-lane tracks over here and we got 2 trains on the line, the moment we want to service a train by lengthening it up a little bit, we can just do one and the other train will still run and the passengers will still come. I mean, it won't be like we had over here with the wood train, you know, where if we take it to the depot, then instantly the wood will not go to the station anymore. So, yeah. You know what, we're just gonna use this depot and we will add some tracks so that this is proper 2-lane. Right, let's do that. I don't really know, but what's this? I don't think we want or need this. Can I somehow prevent that from happening? Would be kind of awesome if I could, but I fear that that's not gonna happen. Doesn't seem. Okay, well, we'll see how this goes. No, it's actually there. It's ugly, but balls. Ah well, I guess we'll just have to live with it. Nice! That actually got rid of that very, very ugly sticking out graphical glitch thing. So, thank you, Switch. Now, seeing how we're gonna operate this as a fully fledged two-lane, part of tracks, we do need to signal this proper. And, here's the thing. This bridge is expensive, so we're not gonna have any bypasses or second tracks right next to it unless we seriously need that when it comes to capacity. So, for now, the signaling is going to be crucial in that, well, we're only gonna... We do need to set this up proper, so let me just get this right, because this stretch over here, you know, this one right here, will be two-directional. This one will always go to the right. So, yeah, how do we set this up proper, really? I'm gonna go around, just get some signals, basically, and we'll see how this goes. Alrighty, well, I think we got everything set up proper now. I'm not really sure on it though. I'm pretty confident about this switch, you know, with everything being signaled proper. All the trains, you know, coming from this direction should go onto the right track straight away. So, you know, this stretch of track right here, this one, should only ever see trains coming into that direction. However, over here, you know, this junction, by the way, I mean, that terrain, man, I can't stand this. We're gonna fix this, because really, okay, we're not going to fix this. I thought I had the power to move the terrain here, clearly I am mistaken. Oh no, there we go. Look at that, that's a lot better. Look at that. Yes, I like it. I mean, it still isn't totally smooth out, but it's better than how it was, alright? We'll leave it at that. Good. Now, like I said, I'm not really sure about this one, though, because we will have trains on both directions on this set of tracks, though I just have a feeling that, I mean, we'll have trains coming like this. I mean, that's one arc, and then we'll also have trains coming like this. But they will just go like so. Yeah, I guess we don't need extra signals. My gut feeling is telling me, and I think it's wrong though, that I'm missing a crucial signal for this junction to work. But assuming that everything is signaled proper, we will be... Yeah, no. All we need to do really is just add some passage, some train passage tracks. So let's quickly get those. I would also like to have one right in front of the station, you know, like over here, for example, but... Well, the train's kind of in the way, so we'll have to wait for that one to be at the station, and then we'll be able to do this. Let's quickly wait. Let's see how it runs into over here and sees way, way too many passengers than it can take. Man, I always love it when we get that much cash. Anyway, we'll build the last passage track right over here. Doesn't need to be big, and then we still need to signal this, and then, only then, are we ready to add the last trains. Or to add the new train, I should say. So, there we go. But you know what, whilst we're at it, we might as well actually add signals to these other ones we've built, you know? Just saying, could be nice so that they actually function, huh? Right then. Okay, so that's that all taken care of. Well, actually, not really, because these ones over here also need signals. Luckily, though, I mean, this bit isn't, as, you know, the difficult bit. It's over here. Like it, so, yes. Right, well, I'm very curious to how this will turn out, you know, like, whether or not all these signals in between is actually a good idea. I think so, because it will allow for, well, compact density on these tracks. Now, if it happens to be that all the trains are running right after each other, then that's not an issue really, but for now we'll just have to see how it goes. So yeah, the new train then, huh? Now, as it stands, the current train I think was lacking like 16 in capacity, but well, at least that was over here. Now, there was roughly around 16 passengers that it just couldn't take. So what we need is like a train, a Borsig train, and oh yeah, of course, there is these bigger and better passenger wagons, you know, that can carry 8. So you know what, because there was like, well, I said 13 to 15 passengers waiting, that's like 2 full wagons, we'll go with 3, you know, extra 3 wagons for now. So that there's a bit of extra capacity for growth as well. So there we go. Now that should all be set up and taken care of. Very nice, very nice. Oh, and now we also have you, and because of issues, yeah, I kind of didn't really foresee this happening. There. Yeah, I guess that this would be the proper way. I mean, the thing is, you know, that because we're using this depot for, well, this line really, we don't need signals over here, because this whole two train situation is only ever going to be from this direction. So there we go, there we are. Now you will be heading over to that station first, and I'm quite curious to see. Ooh, line direction, how is that going, huh? It seems that because these lines are really are like how the trains are going, it seems that our signaling is working just fine as intended. Very nice indeed. Right. Oh, and they're going to be passing each other over here already on these sexy two-lane tracks. Nice, very nice. Just look at the sight of this. Wow, isn't that a beautiful sight to behold? And then there is even a second train. Oh man, wow, we're starting to see Transport Tycoon efficiency and crowdedness on our network, and man, do I love it. Wow man, this is cool. Right, well, oh my good lord, look at this. I mean, Newton Lewillow Station is pretty much exploding with passengers at the moment. Wow, okay. Now, I do wonder, because, I mean, this is all nice, and there's a lot of passengers, but there's only one for Newton Rayleigh. Has that train just left? No, it hasn't. Can't even see where that train's currently at. I believe it's you, though. Yeah, you're the passenger train. How many passengers? Well, you got 8. That's fairly decent, I'd say. Right, so this is kicking in now, but I do wonder what is like the time in between. This isn't good. If it's 22, that means that It's too long, really, you know? It needs to be below the 20 minute mark. I wonder where the holdup was. It could be at either one of these, either one of these stations, you know? Like, this one. Well, actually, that's the only one, because it splits off right over here. It's not good, though. I don't think we'll be making a profit on this line anytime soon. I mean, the train isn't filled up. Far from it, in fact. There's only one wagon filled up. And, yeah, I don't know, really. I don't think we'll be seeing a profit from that one anytime soon. Till we got faster locomotives. I mean, it is, you know, I have to admit, the freaking long distance, but wow. I mean, Newton Le Willows, really, this station is just crazy. Absolutely crazy. But that's alright. Now, the next thing, huh, because, well, you know, this is all going rather nicely. And you have lots of goods. Your production's gone, well, to the normal levels once again. Same over here, so good. Now, this is pretty much taken care of, and this just needs some time to grow. But over here in Rayleigh, same story, it also needs some time to grow. But from Rayleigh over here lies Leominster. And this is, I feel, another opportunity for us to expand our network. Now, Leominster here is peculiar because it is pretty much in an isolated corner of the world, you know? I mean, there are no resources close by. Only Rayleigh is its only, you know, neighboring town because of this big lake. So here's my plan, and I think that's pretty cunning, and it will only add coolness and, well, even longer trains to the network. I think that what we need is we need to provide Leominster with the goods that we make at the sawmill. I mean, I don't see any reason why we shouldn't do that, because any other goods producing facility that is in the vicinity, you know, would be this one. This is the closest one, but there's a freaking hill, you know, blocking any direct traffic, so we would have to go around like this and then pass by all the way to over here. Whilst we could also just use the bridge that we have over the River Kwai over here. I wouldn't say that that's really suited because it's angled wrong. We could have it split off here in a pretty sharp curve, but look at the terrain. It's not really suited for it. So I guess the best solution would be to have a different bridge, so we'll split that one off, you know, and that will just, because then we also don't need to cross these roads at all, I believe, because let's just take a look at what the land use is for Leominster over here. Well, at the moment we start looking, they start developing buildings. Yeah, so the industry section is actually over here, but seeing how Leominster is only ever going to receive goods, we can just have a one lane station here. Though, having said that, you know, when it is growing in capacity and we have multiple trains running the same line, you know, because money, I feel, is less an issue, we're going to future-proof this a little bit, and we're going to go with a two-lane station. But that needs to be here, and then the passengers, that station would need to be over here. So, yeah, it would be quite nice if we can manage to keep the track lines for the goods over here, you know, on this side of the road. And, of course, the passengers will use the same tracks, and it will just branch off. But that's more of a minor issue. Right, I think that we got ourselves some track building to do. So, let's get at it, shall we? Thank you. Alrighty, there we have it. Quite a long stretch of tracks, but it wasn't as costly as I expected it to be, because I like this bridge a whole lot better than I like this monstrous bridge over here. This just goes up way too high, really. But I feel like I've gotten some refinement in bridge building over here. So, yeah, this sure does look a lot better. And wow, look at this, man. This is, I'm pretty sure, one of the most complex track setups that we got. But we're not there yet because, well, here's the thing. What we're going to need is yet another train. And that means that we're going to have 3 trains on this particular stretch over here, which at least for me warrants that we're gonna need a proper 2-lane setup over here. However, the catch is, of course, that we're also going to need some switches, and therein lies the problem, because we only have a very short section of track to get all them switches right, because now what we're gonna need is, we're gonna need probably, this is going to be complicated, because we need to think ahead of how all the trains are going to move. What I think that we're going to need is another junction over here, so that we hook this up there. That way, we will only have traffic going into this direction. You know what, let me just get to building and you'll see how it turns out. I don't really know what's up over here, but clearly something is not right, and I believe that the signals are partially responsible. No? Or no, it's that track piece actually. Right then, let's try and fix that up. I mean, it's not like we're losing money big time on this. Would we also be able to... This is more annoying though, but you can see that, something is definitely bugged on that part, so we're gonna redo that, just so that we can get it right proper. Don't really like that though, it still needs some, well, optimization. That much is pretty much clear. But, oh well. Right, now that looks a lot better. Right then, continuing on. Right, well, I think that I got the signaling right over here. So, what we have over here is basically like a entrance switch for this station where the trains will always be able to get to the right lane. Now, when they're departing, all they would need is this switch. This one's for the arriving trains. So, yeah, and over here there's gonna be traffic going both ways. So I do believe, and it might look very odd, but I do believe that these signals that we got over here are set up the right way, but I don't know, we'll have to see how it functions in reality. For now though, I'm quite happy with this setup, and I think it is time that we get ourselves the very first train which is going to carry goods from this sawmill to Leominster. And let us just quickly find out what the demand is of Leominster. Now, it's only 24, actually. That's not a whole lot. So we'll start out small. We'll start out with just one train, a small train. And we'll see where that takes us. It does mean, however, that I think that the sawmill over here is going to need... well, first of all, it needs... Well, it doesn't really need bigger trains. It needs more trains. Because clearly, bigger is not the solution over here. That much is pretty much... I mean, that is a given fact. By the way, Rayleigh Wood... Yeah, it's a 12-minute drive, but it's doing all right. Yeah. Let's see, just a railway. Yeah, it's not making a profit yet, but... I mean, with such a length, it should make a profit pretty soon, so... Yeah, and once this starts kicking in, we might even want to add another very long train over here, which means that pretty much this whole stretch over here will become two lane, so that it can take care of the load that we have on it. I also made it so that trains coming from any direction can use this depot, so that's also pretty good, but I also made it so that the terrain looks ugly as crap over here. Let's see how far we can get to fixing this. Not really that that good, but oh well. Oh, this one seems to be able to get in a little bit closer to those tracks. I don't know, you know, the moment you get too close to the tracks, it seems as if the game's just saying like, nope, nope, I don't want you touching any of these tracks at all. Which is fair, I mean, I guess, you know, you don't really want that, but... I don't know, I mean, stuff like this, it just needs fixing, you know? I mean, it just looks not right there. Right, well, okay, time to get that train then. Now, as I said, we're gonna start out with a small train, though, then again, it isn't that close, you know? There's quite some distance, so I think it wouldn't be such a bad idea if we start out with, well, how about we start out with actually making a line? That would really help. This is going to be Leominster Wood. So, we'll quickly name that. Leominster Wood. No, not like that. Wood. Right. And, well, like I said, it's only going to be this. And then this. There. Now, the question is, of course, are we gonna have that set up to full load? right from the start. I don't know. I don't think that that would be a good idea, really. So the very first run, maybe the first two runs, we're gonna have it just go. So that the production for Leominster can ramp up on the sawmill over here. So, righty. Now it is time to get the train, which is again going to be a Borsig and a goods wagon. Yeah, we'll start out with 4. I think that will be alright. And Leominster wood. It should actually be Leominster goods, I just now realized. So, let's change this straight away. Goods. There. Good. Rightio. Now, that is all set up. I guess all that's left is for us to activate this. And I don't know if the production is gonna ramp up instantly, but... yeah, this should get ramping up like pretty soon. Right. We'll also disable these ugly contour lines so the water doesn't look like space water with krakens inside and whatnot. Now, this is of course the big test. Will the signals work? Right, well, so far so good. Now, you should go straight. I mean, you should go straight onto the tracks here. If I have signaled everything proper, that is. Yep. Alrighty, nice. And I really like these motions that the signals have right now. I think that adds quite a bit to the game. Now, seeing how you're going to be passing by, I mean, this is going to be an instant good test case of the switches that we got over here. Are they signaled proper? And are they going to be working like they should? We don't really need this to be open. There. Now we know there's a train on the tracks over here, which is actually departing. And... right. So... are we gonna have a collision, or are we not gonna have a collision? That is the question. I think... we're not going to have a collision. Right, very good. This signal over here is doing an outstanding job, if I may say so. And it does make sense that it is waiting over here now, does it? Yeah, because this train had this track we've reserved, you know, it needs to be on this track. I'm just trying to work out whether or not, you know, I've signaled it right and it's working how it should and in the best and most effective way. So, then, well, just figuring this out here. Yeah, that of course is our new goods train, so yeah, it only needed to be at this very station. It isn't the passenger train that we have running over here somewhere, which does need to pass through. So, right. Yeah, this very passenger train over here with 16 passengers. It's starting to kick in over here. Right, very good. How many passengers over here for... yeah, look at that, 15 as well now. Very good. Now, we have these new wagons over here, I believe. So yeah, we can carry a lot more. So there's growth potential in there. What a... ooh, and it's under the 20-minute mark, even. Right. Very, very good. Now, I do wonder, though... I mean... you are full of wood. That's good. But what is your time? Yeah, it's gone up quite dramatically. I see. Though, then again, that isn't a bad thing per se. Because the production is going up right now. So... yeah, because of that rising production over here of Leominster, we've actually bought some future capacity as well. Because where I first thought that we would need an extra, well, we would need this to be 10 long, you know, because there was like 30 waiting, I might have overshot that just a little bit, and now it's waiting too long, because I see over here that the time's gone up to like 19 minutes, and that is a little bit too long, just saying, a little bit way too much actually. Now, how's it going over here? We don't... I mean, this is just running like a charm, it seems. Just look at it. I mean, the switches will always be a point where traffic jams can occur. But as you can see, it is just going, you know, smoothly. Oh, wow. Very nice. How are the passengers doing over here? Yeah, we only have 24, really. But when we open up the line manager, we can see that I think both trains, I see green figures here, green figures only, and you, well, you had green figures, but the arrival of this new train hasn't brought it down in any way. So basically, this is just a win-win situation. Nice, very nice. Right, yeah, that second train that we added over there was definitely needed. I mean, just look at the amount of passengers waiting over here already. That's like 49, and that is including the ones, well, actually, I mean, the ones going from Newton to Featherstone. I mean, wow, 49, look at how many there's are coming over here. It's like the whole town is just emptying out over here on these tracks. Crazy, I tell you. So we have Newton Featherstone. We got the small train coming in with only a 24 capacity, and there are 41 already there. Whilst you, with 42 capacity, you're also filled up. Hold on a second. Does that mean that we simply do not have enough capacity? It seems that our very small train that we got running over here is in need of more wagons. I kid you not, but this ain't... It just can't carry enough. Look, there's 43 waiting and it only has 3 eeny-weeny wagons. Wow. Alright, well, that's interesting. What we're gonna need to do then is... Oh man, look at this. Ew. We're gonna fix this first thing. Look. No, it's not that bad anymore. Not as bad as it used to be. Ah, yeah, I can live with that. Right, no, but just saying, we need to lengthen up this train, and we are going to do just that. However, to do that, and that is part of the issue that we're having right now, we need to use this depot, and that means that the train first needs to go all the way over to over these tracks and then all the way back, and once it's really close over here, only then will we be able to send it to the depot. That needs to happen in before this junction. Actually, that needs to happen before this one. Right, and yeah, and then it will need to go back, so this station will skip out on a full turn. I don't like that, really. Maybe we should add a depot right in over here. I think that that's actually the smarter choice. So we'll do that. We will add a depot over... Oh, there's a hill over there. but this is leading right into the development area of Newton the Willows. You know what? Screw it. We won't build the depot. We'll just use the existing one. So, you know what? We will watch this train. We will see how it does. And we'll get some nice and beautiful shots. You know, some panoramic movie shots. And then we will replace the... Well, we won't replace it. We will add some wagons. That's what I meant. I mean, we couldn't build a depot over here on this land, but Whilst I was looking over here, I see pretty much the perfect flat open space for a depot right over here. So that's what we're gonna do. Unfortunately, I believe that once we send this train to the depot, all these passengers, I think we will, annihilate them into the void or something. I don't really know what happens to them exactly. I do know we won't have them anymore in our train once we're done with them. Actually, we'll take that a little bit further out, just like over there. That should do it. Yeah, that looks about right. Then a depot, and then a, yes, a this, you know, look at that. I always end up building these somewhat lopsided, but I'm cool with that. Although, I mean, symmetry and all that is demanding else, you know, is demanding elsewise. I guess I'm alright with it. Now, we do need the signals to be working proper too, which means over there and over there. Right. Okay then, well, that also means that this train that we got running, you now need to go towards the depot, I believe. Yeah. So, we'll unpause the game. There. And you need to go to the depot right now, which I believe, yeah, look at that. It instantly, basically what just happened is we've just thrown out the passengers, like, in the midst of, you know, the journey, really. So they're standing out there in the field. I can only imagine that's what happened, but it's not really that great now, is it? No. Right, and pause. There. Now, what we're gonna do is we are going to add quite a few more wagons. I'm thinking to add another 3, which means that this train is now 6 long. Yeah, I think that's justified. I mean, the amount of passengers that we just get on over on these stations is just insane, really. Now, we were heading over here and there was already 29 waiting, which was more than we could carry. And imagine, this is only gonna get more and more. This ain't ever going to decrease. I mean, look at this. This is a whole new neighborhood that wasn't here previously that... Wow, you know, it could actually be interesting to see if we could get, like, some sort of surface line going over here. Though, if that were to happen, I think... Well, this is actually industry as well. But if that were to happen, I think we would first need to hook this up. And yeah, I don't think we're going to need to do that right now. But if this starts to develop even further over here, then there's a serious chance that we're going to need to build more tram lines in Featherstone. I mean, Featherstone is just absolutely wrecking it. In terms of like the charts, you can also clearly see how it's just growing like crazy. I approve mightily, though, of course. Though it does seem, you know, it's growing and then it hits like some sort of stagnation phase, really. But I hope that these extra passenger trains that we've just gotten will alleviate that issue. Now, all the passengers to what is it called? A relay. They've just been taken. How much more do you need? You do need quite a bit more, though. How is the... Yeah, the time is 19 minutes right now. Production's gone up wildly, though. So I guess that the amount of wood that you need is gonna get there quickly. I hope. Yeah, I mean, you're spawning like 4 at a time. That means another spawn of this and you'll be on your way. And over here, what do you see? Try to deliver more wood. Yeah, alright. That has to do with our train just waiting over here, really, you know, at the sawmill. So basically, what it comes down to is that we would need more. Well, I don't know really. I think we would need to add another train and then perhaps shorten this one. But I don't know. We'll have to see how it does though. But whether or not we're gonna do that, and if we then need to adjust the tracks over here, is a thing. You'll find out next time when we play more Train Fever.